I've pressed the belt area of the salwar, and I've also put some fabric which is 2 inches by the and also length of the waist. Now I'm using interfacing that we use in poncha, and I will be lining the waist area with this to sort of get it. So as you tie the fabric in with the poncha, I'm using the exact same procedure and just tying the fabric in on the wrong side towards the interfacing, so the interfacing and the fabric are held together. Trim this down, leaving just enough of a margin to stitch on. So this is about a centimeter of sewing allowance. So trim this to size, because I didn't cut this to size, and it's always wise to cut slightly more than less. Now, it's a beautiful, beautiful summer day outside today, and it's quite warm inside. Alright, trim away all the threads. Now, if you look on this side, what we've done is the underside of this is sort of bigger than the top side, and that is so that we can, that gives us allowance for overlapping. And basically what we're going to do is just stitch along, just similar to what you would do on a poncha, leaving slight bit overlapped at the beginning, and just sew all the way. Now, a lot of the very, very professional tailors tend to sew salwars like these. It's not a common practice, but you will have the boutique type of suits that will actually come with the salwar built in this manner. And it is actually a beautiful perfection type of salwar. Now, what we'll do is turn the fabric over towards the interfacing side and stitch on the top of the interfacing, tying the excess fabric that is on the underside of the belt part, and attach this to the interfacing, and that will give you a very, very neat turning. So tie that. This is sometimes, I've probably shown this in some of the videos, doing this with the poncha and also necklines as well. Now, while we're sewing this, I want to just talk about some of the difficulties or some of the qualities of sewing. If you want to make good quality garments, then you know what, be patient with it. Treat the garment with care and pay a little bit attention. Chop away the excess, leaving about a centimeter of space on the fabric. I think the reason why we tend to mess up our sewing is often because we're actually negligent of taking time to... Now, because it's been interfaced, you will get a very nice turning. Turn that over and you can actually stitch on the right side of the garment. And this I would suggest turning on the right side, because you can maneuver the fabric according to how you wish. Now, if you see along here, it's turning accurately by itself. And the reason for that is because we scale stitched all the excess fabric onto. Now, the top fabric is slightly looser than the belt, so what's happening is I'm getting slight bit of creasing, and that's why I'm lifting the foot and gradually sort of easing the fabric into the belt area.